Today I'm showing you how to use Bitstrips for school for the students. To create your account, it is already pre-made, so you're going to click Login. And over here you're going to type in the student code, which is Stucky2. I'm going to click Go. And then you're going to select your name. I have a tester student made, but you'll select yours. And then you'll create a password. Any password that you'd like. Click log in. Now it's going to show you, and your students or your classmates will also be making their avatars, and you can make your avatar by clicking right here, edit your avatar, and you can make it look as close as possible to looking like you. Next thing you'll do to be able to find your activities, this is the assignments that your teacher will assign you. You'll click on the tab that says activities. Obviously, we have one assignment. It's called My Strengths. So I'm going to open it up. It says, show your avatar at school or in the community doing some of the things you are good at. Explain how your strengths and interests affect your learning. There also is a sample comic you can click on. And this can give you some ideas. So one says, I am good at drawing. And shows them in school drawing. It says, being good at drawing helps me do diagrams in science class. When you're ready, you can click Start Activity. This will be starting your assignment. So to get started, you click a layout. So I'm going to click the 4. Then you can do Art Library. And you can click Bitstrip Basics characters. You can do Pets, My Characters. And this is where you can create one right now by clicking New Character. And as you can see, there's Basics. You can also search characters right here. Next, you can click on scenes, and what you do is you just click and drag the scene you'd like. And there are 23 different levels of scenes you can pick from. Then we have props, and you can scroll through all the different types. You can also search. There's furniture, effects, shapes, outfits, and images. Then you can also put text bubbles. So when you have a character, so I'm gonna go grab a character, and then you can text what you want them to say. And with the character, now that you see, controls popped up. So I can click with controls. You can click right here, and it will move your character exactly how you click it to move. And then there's filters. Once you are done, you can click Save, and as you notice down here, there's a lot more tools you can use. You can add panels or remove them, so I can keep adding a panel, or I can make 3, and you can undo and redo, and you can also draw a group lock, but when you're ready, you can do Save, and this is, you can save even if you're not done, and you can edit it by clicking Edit Comic. Or you can submit comic, and that will turn it into the teacher. Later, when you're done, you can also look at the gallery, and that's stuff that the teacher will post of other people's comics. You can look at your comics by just creating ones for fun. You can go look at the characters you've created or make some. And this is how you do it. And go back to the home page. So remember, all your assignments will be under activities. And this is Bitstrips, the student view.